This video, I'm going to give a quick overview of the advanced autopilot setting. You can view the autopilot setting by going to the Amazon Ads campaign section and then clicking on autopilot button. Keep in mind that the autopilot settings are slightly different for manual campaigns as opposed to auto campaigns. For this tutorial, we're going to go through the advanced settings of a manual campaign with keywords because that is more exhaustive, that is more comprehensive. So clicking on the autopilot setting brings up the basic setting, which is switch on and exhaust target. This should suffice in the beginning. They should be okay. As time goes by, you know, you can see how your campaign is performing and you can go to the advanced options. I'll walk you through the advanced options one by one, what they do and how you can utilize it best. So the first is the exhaust average days. When you say an exhaust target, the exhaust is calculated by the number of days over here. You should not do it on every day exhaust because exhaust fluctuates. The data constantly changes for the last few days, at least for the 2 or 3 days. So it's best to keep it stable and calculate the exhaust for the last 7 days. So when we say hit a target of 30%, it calculates the exhaust for the last 7 days by default, which you can change it and make it up to 20. 7 is pretty good. Some people prefer to keep it for the last 20 days because it gives it the campaigns more stability. Autopilot goal. This is actually a very critical part of autopilot setting. There's either increased sales or lower ad cost. When you say increased sales, the autopilot bid will always increase the bid if the keyword or the target has a lower ad cost than the target. So let's assume your ACOS target is default 30% and there are a couple of keywords with an ACOS of 10%. If the goal is increased sales, then autopilot will increase the bid of this keyword until it reaches the ACOS of 30%. If the autopilot goal is lower ad cost, then autopilot will not increase the bid of those keywords if it is less than the ACOS target. On the other hand, if the ACOS target is more than 30%, then regardless of what you choose, autopilot will always decrease the bid. So the goal is only when the keyword ACOS or target ACOS is lower than the target, then what do you want to do? Do you want to increase the sales and risk a higher ACOS, or do you want to just keep the ad cost low? Very crucial, you know, depending on what your objectives are. Usually, the default is always to increase your sales. Jumpstart bid is one more critical part of it. Let's assume you have a campaign that has performed really well in the past, maybe 60 days ago or 90 days ago, but in the last couple of weeks, the performance has really drastically fallen off. There are no sales, maybe, or the spend is too high, or you change the bids manually and something went wrong. So the campaign is not performing really well. So you can switch on jumpstart bid for a couple of weeks. And what this does is autopilot will look up the best performing bid in the last 1 year, and then it'll jump that bid from the current bid to the previous really high performing bid. So for example, if your bid is around $3 right now and it detected that in the past it really performed well at 60 cents, then it would jump to 60 cents. It's not for all situations, but in times where a campaign performance has drastically fallen and you don't know what is going on, or maybe you made changes to the bid and you can't go back to the previous bid, then switch on jumpstart bid for a couple of weeks. The campaign will try to recover the performance based on historical performance. So minimum spending threshold is the minimum spend below which autopilot will not reduce the bid. It will always try to increase the bid. The default is $1. So if there is a keyword or a target which has spent less than $1, maybe 20 cent or 30 cent or 40 cent, and it has not made any sale, autopilot will not reduce the bid for this. It will keep on increasing until the total spend for the last 7 days has exceeded $1. Remember, this is not the individual bid, but this is the total spend for the last ACOS average days. So in the last 7 days, over here in this example, if it has spent $1, then the autopilot will kick in and try to increase or decrease the bid. But if in the last 7 days the spend is less than $1, then autopilot will not reduce the bid. That's because it's a premature optimization. The minimum spending threshold is the aggregate of the spend for a particular keyword for the total across average days. The other is the maximum auto bid allowed, which is what is the maximum auto bid allowed for a particular keyword or for a particular target. One caveat to keep in mind is that if your current bid is already higher than the maximum auto bid, then Autopilot will not increase the bid. But if it is performing really well, then it won't decrease the bid either. So for example, if your current bid for a keyword is $5 and the ACoS is really good, you know, it's around 20% when your target is 30%, then because the maximum Autopilot bid is 3, it won't increase the bid from 5 to any more higher than that. It will decline. It will show in the logs that circuit breaker has hit, but it won't decrease the bid as well. So it will be stuck at $5. But if the performance is bad, then it will keep on decreasing until it reaches, you know, reasonable performance. And once it goes below 3, then it will go up and down. So that is a something to keep in mind. So maximum auto bid allowed. Assuming in a normal situation where all the bids are below this maximum auto bid, it won't go above this $3 per keyword for the bid, which is usually perfect, you know, for most of the product. But there are some high expensive products where you might need a higher auto bid, so you can make it to 3, 4, or 5. You know, there are some supplement sellers that go all the way up to 20, but as a rule of the thumb, you know, 3 is pretty good. Autopilot velocity is how fast do you want the bid changes to happen. So let's assume the current bid is around $3 and there are no sales. Autopilot would generally increase it, you know, by a few cents depending on the performance, depending on the past performance. So it might go from $3 to 3.2 cent or 3.5 cent, again depending on the performance of the keyword. If you push it to faster, then it'll go from $3 to $3.50 or $3.60, so it'll make a huge change. So that's a huge risk of, you know, overshooting the target, but you will find out, you know, what is a good performance really quickly. The risk of, you know, faster is you lose a bit of money, but the advantage is you will know what is a good bid very quickly. On the other hand, you can make it slower. You know if the campaign is performing really well, it has reached your, you know, target ACoS, you're very well satisfied with the, you know, Autopilot, how it is working, then it's recommended to put it at the slower. So there's very tiny changes being made every single day. It'll just make sure that your performance, you know, your competitors don't bid and take over you. So it'll always keep, you know, your campaign running smoothly and slowly. Placement boost is the boosting percentage for top of the page, the detail page, and other places. Usually what people do is they set up, you know, a fixed percentage and then forget about it. With placement boost, you can Autopilot automatically calculates what is the best percentage for, you know, top of the search, what is the best percentage for the detail page, what is the best percentage for other, and then it'll keep on updating every single day. One thing to keep in mind is that placement boost is required to be switched on for automated day parting. Automated day parting won't work without the placement boost. That is because the day parting uses the placement boost to decide, you know, how much the placement boost should be depending on the time of the day. We won't worry too much about automated day parting. We'll cover in a different video. Remove bad keywords. So this is usually required when you have lots of keywords. Some people stuff their campaigns with, you know, 40, 50, 100, I've seen 900 keywords. Remove bad keywords means if a keyword performance is really bad. And how do you know keyword performance? That's a separate video again. If the keyword performance is really bad, if it has historically performed bad and we think it's never going to perform, then Autopilot will never act on this keyword. It will just, you know, remove it. It will just whack it and not increase the bid for it at any time. The opposite end of it is if you have, you know, very few keywords in a campaign, you added 4 or 5 keywords and you want to continuously add new optimal keyword, then you switch this on and the new keyword is added by the customer search term. So it filters out all the customer search terms, find the best performing customer search term, and then automatically adds it to the campaign. You usually keep it at 1 because every day you just want to add 1 top customer search term. 1 is the maximum. It doesn't necessarily mean it'll definitely add 1, but it'll try to find at least 1 good customer search term. If it finds it, it'll add it. If not, it won't. at it. Top Amazon suggested keyword. This is again Amazon recommendation. We strongly recommend you not to use this and keep it at zero. In fact, Autopilot will refuse to add top Amazon suggested keyword unless you're, you know, none of your keywords are performing well. This is because most of the recommendations are absolute garbage. They're bid recommendation, keyword recommendation, they're all geared towards making a higher ad spend, not making towards higher ad revenues. So always keep this zero. If you know some of your campaigns are really performing bad, there are no good keywords, then you can make it one or two. So when you add a new keyword, the bid that is chosen is always a bid aggression. So let's assume it finds a customer search term, and then it calculates that the bid for it is $3. Because it's a new keyword, we don't know if the performance at $3 is going to be good. The AI says it's $3. But we don't want to take the risk. We don't want to be over aggressive. So we choose a bid aggression, which is 10%. So it will choose 10% of $3, which is 30 cents, and it will start off with 30 cents. And Autopilot will, of course, increase it gradually. If it thinks it's performing, then it will keep on increasing it. So new keyword bid aggression is when the new keywords are automatically added. How much aggressive do you want to be with the new keywords? If your campaigns doesn't have, you know, enough sales and you want to increase the sale, you can increase the top customer search term to 2 or 3, and then you can increase the bid aggression to 50 or 70. This way, when new keywords are added, the bids are already really high, and you get sales. The drawback is, again, of course, you know, as with everything else, you might overshoot your budget, and initial few weeks you might have a really high spend. If you keep the top customer systems really high, and you keep the keyword aggression, then every day there could be, you know, new, could be possible, you know, new search terms, and with the high aggression, you're spending more and more. So the campaign never stabilizes. Good idea to keep it one. This you can, you know, increase it whatever you want, depending on, you know, how much sales you want to generate with the new keyword. Automated departing is not something I want to talk about. It takes a long time. The AI, you know, will also analyze your campaign, wait for sales, and then decide how much to boost on a peak day or on a slow day. It boosts the percentage of the placement boost, so make sure placement boost is switched on for automated departing.